are live. Super Crazy Pro Wrestling presents Heartbreak. I am the voice of Super Crazy Pro Wrestling, Big Sexy Ben Rivers, and I would be joined here by my colleagues, but I think they're still on break. We're about to get to this action. Let's go, David Adams.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Pine Grove Civic Association here in Gloucester City, New Jersey, as this afternoon, Super Crazy Pro Wrestling in the Skid Row Academy proudly presents
Filmed
in ultra high tech 4K, so we are
gonna
make this shine
4K, 4K, 4K,
4K. Super crazy action. Our Heartbreak event kicks off right now with your opening bout of the afternoon scheduled for one fall.
Heartbreak. So making her way to the table, the new voice of Super Crazy Pro Wrestling, Atiya Harris. You're the new voice. I'm the old voice. You're the new voice. Chris Slade. Chris Slade. I'm not very familiar with him. I'm very familiar with Chris Slade, but I hear very good things. Oh, okay. I'm very familiar with his opponent.
Well, there's a lot going on with Slade. He has a history here.
Does he? A history here is super crazy? Or a history,
he was
period?
The first
ones
here.
Nah. Chris Slade?
And he's just coming off of a match with Matt Riddle.
Oh.
So he's doing his thing. He's out in the middle.
Oh. Okay. All right, Chris Slade. Handle that. Well, this guy right here is about to give him a run for his money.
For sure. Now, they're both agile, flexible.
It's like two of the same styles collide. The Menace from Mars.
So this is going to be an interesting match for sure.
Look at him. Look, he's a contortionist. Look, look. If I try to do that, I'm not getting back up.
I'm breaking everything. Oh, my back. Oh, my neck.
That's what you're going to hear. Ah, my back. Ah, my back. Ah. Now, Rocket, no stranger to Super Crazy Pro Wrestling. This man has been making waves up and down the East Coast, all over the U.S.
How long have you been growing your hair, bro?
Just coming off of a win versus Tim Dynamite, as a matter of fact.
Now we got to because we got to let the hair down. Hold
Speaking
up,
of Fully Charged, Fully Charged, a full show is up on the Super Crazy Pro Wrestling official YouTube channel. So if you weren't there, you missed out on a hell of a show. Catch it on YouTube.
Subscribe while you're there.
Yeah, I'm all good.
And join us here for our next Fully Charged, which I believe is the end of the month, 23rd, something like that.
Yep, it's 23rd. It's Friday, 23rd.
So I guess we're not getting a dance off?
It's a sportsmanship, a handshake. Oh, okay.
Well, usually with Rocket, we get a dance off or something.
Right back up on this piece, Slade.
Hey, let's get it, baby.
Looks like they both did their homework on each other.
Frog.
Oh, yeah, look at that. Can I just say, it has nothing to do with the match, but how great is it to have David Adams back in Super Crazy Pro Wrestling? That man, wow, he's a legend.
You're doing way too much.
Sorry, I just had to put that out there.
For sure, yeah.
It's been a while. David Adams is my homeboy. Ooh, ouch.
Street Fighter.
Boom.
In second.
Talk about a jawbreaker. Whee.
Okay, like that.
That was a cocky pin by Rock.
Slade kicked out by also a little twist to the
corner.
I don't think in my entire wrestling career I've ever seen a pin actually successful that way.
I don't think so either.
Wow, he caught him in the back of the neck. You saw that? Crack! Ah, my neck.
Ah, and the two count again. Are they already out of steam, or are they thinking about
their next? No, I think, they're thinking about their next move because, yeah, as you notice, they've had an answer to every call they've been sending out to each other.
Looks like Rocket is taking himself out to get a break, a little bit of air. Oh!
Right. See, now most people would say that's unwise because then you put yourself in a situation like we just witnessed.
Look at how Slade walked that off, though.
Of course, because Rocket broke his fall. Rocket broke his fall, and Slade broke Rocket. But what a way to start Heartbreak.
Slade is going up to the top rope. What is he up to?
Okay. I want to say that was a corkscrew moonsault.
Either way, it was.
Unsuccessful. Countered by a cross body. Okay. Helicopter. Wow. Shoulder up at the last second there. That was almost. But like any good competitor knows, it all it takes is that one mistake. For that three
face
count.
First into the turnbuckle.
Okay.
Pretty hefty chop there. Okay, with the right. I would say Market is not really going for his strikes. Okay, so he's breaking out of that.
But when someone is just as athletic. And just as agile as you are, you got to think outside the box sometimes and start coming out of your comfort zone.
Oh, devastating knee.
I think I saw a two.
Going for the cover.
Two.
Just the two.
Trying to put him away.
What else can they bring out of each other?
Okay. Feeding off this crowd, Slade in complete control right now.
Picture perfect.
Looked like he was going.
Looks like he was going for something, and it got cut off completely. And wait, wow!
He got it with the running Pele kick.
Wow, that was.
He got it with Get Pro.
Is that what that's called?
What an amazing. Rocket, what a great victory.
I think Chris Slade definitely got pro. I don't expect anything less from the Menace from Mars.
Yes.
You got thrown! Listen to his music. It just makes you want to dance.
I don't even dance.
I don't either. But you just let the music tell you how to dance. Watch when the beat drops. Just do it. Now you folks at home can't see the garbage that's happening right here at this table right now.
This is the reason why we're behind the mic and we are not out there.
Exactly.
Great match to start out with.
Man, what an opening contest. Let's hear it for both of these super crazy studs.
Oh, let's hear it for David Adams!
We're just getting started, and I think it's about time for a title fight. Y'all want to see a title fight?
Wow.
We are super
title defense in our second match?
Skid Row Academy as Heartbreak continues with this next bout of the afternoon scheduled for one follow-up. And it is for the Super Crazy Pro Wrestling Women!
I've been looking forward to this. We haven't seen Damaris Dawkins in quite some time. Shout out to senior referee Nick Shin in the ring.
Oh, okay. This sounds like it's La Chica Clara
Carreras.
And
I think it was in the same situation. Challenger for the women's championship.
So she's back again. Maybe this time she'll be lucky and grab herself a win.
I mean, it's too soon to tell.
Sure.
But Damaris has been women's champion for so long for a reason.
That is also true. I'm interested in seeing how they bring out each other's styles.
They've had time in between to do homework on each other.
Damaris bring that technical style, that Philly technical style.
Dawkins has a great track record.
Good lockup. Taking control of
Pro Wrestling R Women's Champion. I believe she was ACPW Women's Champion. Current Super Crazy Pro Wrestling Women's Champion.
Definitely
a lot of accolades.
Go ahead, watch the pro ladies.
Got a roll through. And reversal into.
Wow.
That's a lot.
A lot of beautiful chain wrestling going on there. I love this. Wrestling.
Right now the match is favoring Dawkins' technical style more so than Clara's lucha style.
Wrestling!
Clara to take Damaris a little bit out of that to her own world, to her own territory. territory.
It's two very unique styles. Right back to the cover. Okay. Wow. Someone just moo?
Either moo or boo.
I'm gonna go with moo because it sounds funny.
Yeah, angry cow.
Ooh.
Ouch.
How do those feet taste?
Did take a little bit of avatars with the drum kicks.
There's one thing I know about Tamar. She, when she's backed into a corner, she's unpredictable.
Just two.
Forearm. Ouch. Those hurt.
Strikes to the midsection.
Those hurt too. Body shots to make your body rock. Or wait. Sorry. It was a Daniel Alexander reference.
Face into the turnbuckle.
Eat it. Dawkins to win that women's championship.
Yeah.
Damaris has to fight to keep it. Beautiful. Is that a sunset flip?
No.
still up. Still up. Still up. She's still up.
That was a brilliant slam. Let's see if she can capitalize it.
Carrera's favoring that left arm, the elbow. Very dangerous spot for both of them. Hell, it's a dangerous spot for anybody.
That was pretty nasty.
Okay. What?
We just got a new champion.
We got a new women's champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, who is your winner? And new
powerbomb head.
Super Crazy Pro Wrestling Women's Champion, Lashita.
Chica Clara.
But I have no control over it. The Latin inside me is just going nuts.
The sportsmanship from Damaris Dawkins. She shakes her hand and promptly leaves the ring to allow her opponent to enjoy the victory. If you're just tuning in, this is Super Crazy Pro Wrestling, and the event is Heartbreak.
And we just got a new women's champion, folks. Clara Carreras is the new Super Crazy Pro Wrestling women's champion.
That's amazing.
Hats off to women's wrestling. And I'm still shimmying here. I have no control over my body right now. Get money.
Oh boy. Old Dog has just asked me to make a huge announcement. Oh. Here at Gloucester City, New Jersey, it is now Shot.
Okay, so, Tia, I'll see you in a few. It's shot o'clock.
Okay.
Be right back, folks.
You should see the people running over.
We're about to take away from our next match.
Well, I'm still right here.
As the action continues right now at Heartbreak with your next bout scheduled for one fall.
Oh, we all know this music by now. It's the real deal.
Boobs from the crowd. with me. I know you do.
Speaking of his opponent, recognize the music from the mean streets.
His opponent, he is bringing
Tim Dynamite. £175 versus 300 pounds. I will say this, Tim Dynamite is quite serious looking on his face right now. Maybe it's a little bit of a different attitude. You know what? He might be in his head right now because he did lose his previous match to Rocket on Fully Charged this past January.
I'm on the ropes, back him up!
It's going to be interesting to see what the 175-pound Dynamite can do to 300-pound Goldstein.
Thank you for the weapons check. The rules. Now I get to check you. Come here. No. There's nothing in the rules that says I can't check you.
Of course, with the size difference, there's a style difference.
Ready, go see.
Come on, Dynamite.
Ring the bell.
Dynamite is stepping
up. Back him up.
As Goldstein is kind of backing away once more. Everyone in the crowd is for Dynamite right now, for the Crucible Tim Dynamite.
Yeah, the Crucible Tim Dynamite. We're back, folks. We got Popeye the Sailor Man versus Tim Dynamite. No, folks, that's Mike Goldstein. He's a seasoned veteran in this business. He's been around longer than I have.
Kind of disrespectful how he's deciding to just sit in the audience.
Okay. But you know what? That could be a plot towards something bigger.
I just want to do the handshake.
But just one thing about Goldstein.
We can call it Dakota Crazy. We'll call it Dakota Crazy, right?
Captain Caveman. To me, it was just anger.
Bell rang. Oh, okay, so we should be getting counted out, though, if he's going to sit on the sidelines.
Never mind.
If he's trying to anger Dynamite, that may not be a good idea.
I mean, but look at the size difference.
Yes, I did mention the size difference. Tim Dynamite at 175 pounds and Goldstein at 300. Oh, starting with the chops and he strikes back and forth.
This is a fight!
Very aggressive side. Oh.
Wow!
Got cut off with a push. Standing drop kick.
He's like, I will not be made a fool of.
Pele kick. Taking him out by the legs. That's a good strategy.
Wow! Wait a minute!
Where did this side of Tim Dynamite come from?
Where's this intensity?
He never let up, not for a second.
Come on! Where's the real deal?
He's getting behind Dynamite. Boom! A double axe hammer!
Stunning his opponent a little bit, but not off his feet quite.
That's called taking out the garbage.
Catching his breath a little bit, composing himself. It looks like Tim Dynamite is about to do something new. Oh, okay. Almost.
Come in.
Yep. Oh! Took him out by the leg. Send him to the apron on the ring.
Did he just say who's the real deal?
I said that.
I know who the real deal is for real, and his name is Shaheem Ali. He's the real deal for real.
I don't think he cares right now, but
You right.
Pretty heavy stunts coming from. Goes deep into an elbow drop. Definitely Tim should be that right now.
I mean, that's 300 plus pounds. Dropping down on your chest. This is...
Oh,
That's a bear. Yeah, that's a. Now that is a bear hug. Chiropractor, you're gonna need a physician.
Finish
in 10. You're gonna have to get Tim Dynamite a spa day after this one. See, now this is where those mistakes come in. Like, instead of showboating, you should have stayed on him, ended the match quickly. Tim Dynamite should not be underestimated. Well, the only thing Mike Goldstein is doing is angering Tim Dynamite.
Just massive hand.
I can slow you down without
pushing down on the face of Tim Dynamite.
You cheater! Come here.
Back into the mirror.
How's that back feel?
Oh.
I promise you I would do some elbow. Okay, maybe not. Wrenching him around.
Fans telling Goldstein how they feel about him. Goldstein sucks. Listen, at this point, there's no reason to deny Dynamite. He's had a very illustrious path here in Super Crazy Pro Wrestling.
Ducking.
Former Skid Row heavyweight champion. I've never seen a spear come out of Tim Dynamite. One, two, oh.
I've never seen him do it on the sides of somebody like Goldstein.
And I stand corrected. Tim Dynamite has done a spear. I need to start paying attention. No, no, no. You the voice. And good job.
Tim Dynamite is waiting.
Stalking him. This is it. Could it be the trials?
It's a trial.
He's trying to go for the trials and tribulations.
I don't know if that
was. It's kind of hard to do that on a 300 plus pound man.
Exactly. Yeah. Try a different situation.
No. Right back into that bear hug. At this.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is so great. We have a pin coming in. And Tim Dynamite pulls the win over Mike Goldstein. Well done with the schoolboy pin. And that is the reason why you cannot deny Tim Dynamite. He started out this match with aggression that you have not seen before, or at least in a little while from him. Tim Dynamite saw his opponent, Mike Goldstein, made a decision and stuck to it. Goldstein right now is looking a little puzzled as to was it two or was it three? Sorry, Mike Goldstein, it was indeed three. You may be the real deal, but you are not the Crucible. What else could we possibly bring you today at Heartbreak here at Super Crazy Pro Wrestling? I don't know. I'm learning as things happen as well.
What a matchup we just saw. Tim Dynamite victorious here. The concession stand open for business. Remember, throughout the show, in intermission, your favorite stars will be out here for autographs, to sell the merch, meet and greets. Check it out.
I'll be right back.
And don't forget, we'll have Super Crazy Pro Wrestling YouTube channel, the only place you can find the official version of Heartbreak being shot in our ultra-high-definition 4K cameras, making the stars shine even brighter than they already
got it in 4K, yes.
As the action continues, it's our next title fight of the afternoon.
Another title fight.
And it's for the Super Crazy Pro Wrestling
Heavyweight Championship. Oh, this is going to be interesting.
Oh, the true Skid, Super Crazy. I almost said Skid Row there. That would have been disrespectful. The true Super Crazy Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Champion. Yes, I said it. The real and true Super Crazy Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Champion. My man, Tony Leyenda, being accompanied by Tone Bennett, the Tonys.
Yes, I did have a conversation, a quick one. He graced me with his presence. Tony Leyenda said to me, he said, he is the only true heavyweight champion, and he will tell that to anyone.
And how did that feel to be in the presence of the true heavyweight champion, huh? Did it make you all tingly, wingly inside?
As a commentator, I say unbiased, thank you very much.
That means yes, folks. She was all tingly, wingly inside.
Romance is saying tingly, wingly sounds weird.
Listen, this is a family show.
You're saying
I can't say what I want to say. Tingly, wingly. That's the true champ in there.
He's actually been reigning for almost 2 years.
Yep. Well over 700 plus days as the real Super Crazy Pro Wrestling champion.
First of all, everybody shut up because we got something to say.
We don't care.
Yeah, shut up. Everybody shut up.
That's just disrespectful.
When it comes to SKPW,
it's disrespectful to interrupt the champ.
For 2 years, today, when they say champ, the only performance of one person. This title's from everywhere. In the States, back home to the Great Dominican Republic, and the step of champ stays champ. But here's one other thing that you guys need to take note of. After tonight,
you suck.
Not only La Malita Guerra going to be SKPW heavyweight champion, no. I'm talking about the great. He's big. Tony Bennett will own with Big King. Championship on that. Your favorite, right? What's his name? Soriano.
Oh, and, he's talking about that inner room guy. What's his name? The supermarket. Super Fresh.
And you can sit on that.
Yeah, you hear that?
I don't know.
Oh, speak.
Somebody.
I spoke him into existence.
You know, if you say. Adrian Soriano 3 times. He's gonna show up like the boogeyman.
I only said it once.
Okay, well, maybe.
Actually, I didn't even say his name. All I said was Super Fresh.
That's all you need to do. Say Super Fresh, he'll show up.
There's a bunch of talk coming from a couple of guys who've done nothing but duck and dive for the past several months.
Let's talk about it.
Yeah, plenty of opportunities to put that title against me, Tony Leyenda.
All over the world.
Listen, he likes to call himself La Crema. El Champion.
What does
I like to think your name is Tony Leyenda.
La Crema, yeah, La Malita Crema.
I don't speak Spanish.
Well, it is Spanish.
Okay.
It stands for the cream. The cream of the crop.
Oh, the crop is called
the interim Super Crazy Heavyweight Championship only exists.
I mean, you can't call a champion a coward. He's a champion.
They just did, though.
That's, I mean, yeah, but none of them will go toe-to-toe with the real champion.
And as for your partner, Tony Bennett, You can thank Tony La Hienda for the ass beating that you're going to get later today.
Oh, we have a
magic
between Tony Bennett and
Chris Riano later. That's later, and this is now. So Tony La Hienda, allow me to introduce to you your opponent for your match. The guy who may have you a run for your money. The captivating Homeless Vaughn.
Oh.
Homeless Vaughn. Now.
Homeless Vaughn versus
now. I have seen this before, and it was Homeless Vaughn who defeated... Nah, never mind. He did not. He did not, because La Hienda was forced to vacate his United States Championship.
It's been a long history between all these people, and he felt,
however,
sometimes we cannot.
However, in one of his first title defenses, did defeat La Hienda in La Hienda's attempt to regain that United States championship.
Yeah, Homeless Vaughn has secret homeless man strength, and you cannot underestimate that. The crowd seems to always love him. Okay, he's having trouble getting it. You're in. You're good. You're in.
You know, as many times he's gotten in and out of the ring, you think he'd have it by now.
A little dance going, okay.
How can you not dance?
It's a classic.
It's a classic song.
Hear that crowd chanting on Homeless
Vaughn. Leyenda! Leyenda!
All by yourself. All by yourself.
No respect for the real champ. That's horrible. Y'all folks. These fans here have no respect for the real champion.
Nick Shin holds up the title.
I got mad respect for senior official Nick Shin.
Of course. They chant, give him a dollar.
I mean, he's got to eat.
Inflation, but you can probably get something.
Nah. maybe a pack of gum. Maybe some Winter Fresh juices or something. Maybe two of them if you're lucky.
Okay, got Homeless Vaughn sort of mimicking Tony. Ready?
That's all
legal. He says time out.
He just smells it. Hey, he's in those ropes. He's in the ropes. That's all
away
legal.
From Homeless Vaughn.
There's nothing I can do with that, man. That's all legal. Get it in here.
Whoa. I mean, Homeless Vaughn stinks. I can attest that to that. He had me in a headlock, and that armpit.
He's a true champion. He will face anyone in any condition.
Listen, but there's got to be rules. There's got to be rules to personal hygiene. But yeah, that's all that bacteria and all that germs. That's gross. That is gross.
Homeless man with Julie right here.
I think of all the oil and grease and dirt he's just putting all over the champ. Ew. Yo, that's nasty. Wow. Okay, Vaughn.
Now
I hate to bring this up, but you gotta wonder what role Tone Bennett will play in this match. Not saying he's a cheater or anything, you know, the Tonys are pure competitors, but you never know.
Look at that,
wow, all for them, right over.
It looks like so far Tony Bennett is they are giving requests to Homeless Vaughn to strike Tony.
You stop!
Strong right. Reverse from the corner into the
right back.
Oh! Foot to the face. That caught him from a crossbody. drops him, but he lands on his feet. A lot of prowess from these two.
Hey, watch a little drink. Don't spill that on me.
Oh! Almost Vaughn's finally get his way up. Strong kick to the midsection, and another one. Tony stops him dead in his tracks and brings a strike down to his back.
Off the ropes and off the hair.
Strong right from Tony. Placing the foot on the throat of Homeless Bond. At this point, I want to remind you guys, if you go to YouTube, you can look up Super Crazy Pro Wrestling by typing in the at symbol Super Crazy Pro. That's at SuperKrazePro.
Yeah, what she said. Champ is giving it to Vaughn right now.
Backbreaker. Oh, Homeless Vaughn bounced like a basketball with that one.
You said a basketball.
Watch the hair, man. Come on.
He's probably full of air like a basketball. He can fly. He can float.
The crowd is still 100% behind him. Elbowed his way out.
I wonder if this crowd is being biased.
Beautiful sunset flip. Oh, I'm gonna get to 2.
There's gotta be some type of biasness behind that. Like, are you just backing Homeless Vaughn because he's homeless?
Why gotta do all that?
Well, you know, sometimes you feel sorry for the homeless people. Have you ever given to a homeless man on the side, like, I need some food, or I'm hungry, God bless you?
I never applauded him for what he was doing. Homeless Ron does things time and time again. Bending the back of Homeless Vaughn as well.
Do not put your hands
up. Look at that, Tony.
He's not cheating. That's not cheating.
That's exactly
that's perfectly fine. You step out of the ropes. That's your fault. All is fair in love and war.
He is not part of this match right now.
Yes, he is. He's there for moral and emotional support.
Pull him back down again.
I hope everybody's taking notes. This is what real champions do. There it is. Yep. See, and that's why he's a champ. Real
one. But still can only get that 2 points. Crowd for some reason wanted to remind Tony that that's not PG.
What's not PG? The thrusting of the hips?
I suppose.
It's covered. It's covered.
Knee after knee to the midsection. Taking the air.
Those big knees.
Tony does have some long legs, which makes for a great long weapon, for sure.
Exactly.
Whoop! Snake eyes.
Now he got some food.
He did not take Tony off his feet, though.
Ew, he's barefooted, though. Ew.
On a clothesline. Getting a little bit more energy. First. Into the turnbuckle. Hitting back with a elbow and the kick.
Arn is still in there. Wow.
Is he gonna go for the cover? Yes.
Nah.
Oh.
Nah.
He gets a two. The champ kicked out. Oh, you know it gets serious when Homeless Blonde takes off the shirt.
But he needs to put it back on. Anybody got that Febreze?
Don't be mad. He got a little bit of homeless abs happening.
Listen, I ain't homeless and I ain't even got no abs. But I don't need a six pack when you got the whole kid.
That's philosophical right there. I can't
right. Fist a lot. All day. Fist a lot. It's like an effort.
Ducked out of the way of that kick. Oh!
Wow, at the last second.
These two
wow.
are throwing everything at each other at this moment.
1, 2, and so we came up, man. Nothing I can do with that, too.
Wow. That's biscuits and gravy right there.
Nick Shin saying there's nothing I can do. That was a 2.
And that's why he's a senior official.
He calls things straight down the middle.
Straight down the middle. No favorites, no none of that. He can't be bought. Where's this coming from?
Backslide. Can we get it? Just a 2. Bring the kick.
Broke it.
Whoa.
Hit that broke it.
There it is.
Oh.
That's got to be it, folks. That's got to be it. There's no way. That's it. I told you.
Tony Leyenda wins. With Starstruck. Still defending champion. Super Crazy. Wrestling. Champion.
You see?
But let's not, you know, neglect the fact that Homeless Bond put up a really good fight.
He tried. He definitely gave 110%.
Tony Bennett has his cup of his drink of choice right now.
At the end of the day, the real champ is the real champ for a reason.
Wait. Why? What are they doing? Oh, pouring it in his face.
Did they force him to take a sip?
Poured it into his mouth.
Tony Bennett was like, sip on this.
Wait.
What is no?
Tony Bennett just handed Tony Leyenda a pair of scissors.
No.
What are they up to?
No, here comes Primal Fear. Primal Fear chasing off the Tonys.
Primal Fear coming to the aid of Homeless Bond. See, that's what a champion does.
What, wins his match?
Comes to the aid of other people, does what's wrong.
Man. That's how you lose your champion. You start trying to make friends. Although, I do not condone the real champ's actions. It was a little over the top and over the line. So respect to Primal Fear for
Homeless Bond to say thank you to Primal Fear. He's very thankful. It looked like the Tonys were going to cut Homeless Bond's hair for some reason.
I wouldn't want his dress. I'm surprised he
didn't. Oh, they didn't pay the light bill again?
No. This has been happening more and more frequently here.
Yes.
Lights just been going off. Ominous messages. What?
Oh.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Okay. Oh.
And it's the
silent assassin.
Zach Ravitch.
With a spinning kick.
Why can't you just leave him alone?
Vaughn. Homeless Vaughn just got laid out by the silent assassin, Zach Rabbit.
These two.
Oh no, he's great. Picking up the scissors.
I wouldn't touch those if I were you. Ew, you about to cut off them locks.
The crowd wants this to happen?
Why? Wait, weren't they just behind Homeless Vaughn?
I'm so confused. Maybe they don't like the haircut. I don't know.
Or where's your precious primal fear now?
Just cut the dreads off of them. Hold it up as some sort of momentum.
I'm in shock.
Memento.
The fresh golden locks. I don't know how else to describe it. The doo-doo locks.
Oh my god!
Man, take that pile of doo-doo off your head.
Homeless Vaughn is now pretty much cradling in his hands.
You never saw the medical professor?
I saw the medical professor.
You're just Vaughn now. You're not homeless.
He took your hair.
Oh no, you might need to
keep it. Well, he didn't take it because Vaughn's got it.
Zach!
Wait, oh, yo, hold on.
He grabbed a knife from
He's got the scissors.
Okay.
The same scissors that chopped the golden locks off.
I thought it was a shank for a second.
I did too, but I don't think Homeless Vaughn has been to prison.
With a shout to Zach Rabbit, he grabs the scissors from his cart with intention.
We've got a little bit of craziness at the conclusion of that match. What we're going to do here is we're going to regroup. We're going to take a brief intermission. The concession stand is open for business. Food and refreshments. Primal Fear will be out here with their merchandise. Many of your other Super Crazy and Skid Row Academy stars. I'm David Adams. This is Heartbreak. We'll be back in just a little bit with the explosive second half of our February Star-Studded Spectacular.
Well, that's it, folks. You saw the first half. We're at intermission. Tia, you know what time it is. It's time to get some of that checking.
Welcome back to Super Crazy Pro Wrestling Heartbreak. I'm Atiyah Harris sitting with you, never left, the new voice of Super Crazy.
Yes, the new voice of Super Crazy Pro Wrestling, Atiyah Harris. Good job!
If you're just showing up, we are in the second half of Heartbreak, but we still have a lot of things going on for you, for your entertainment pleasure.
Get back to David Adams.
David Adams, the professional.
The explosive second half is coming at you. On this camera business, follow me. You know we in 4K all day long. You can check us out on the YouTube channel of Super Crazy Pro Wrestling.
Yep, and that's at Super Crazy Pro. At symbol SUPERKRAZEEPRO.
You had to spell it out completely.
I mean, why not?
And we are back.
How do you spell crazy?
How you see it on those banners?
How you're not going to see it unless you go to the YouTube channel?
Super Crazy.
True.
YouTube channel.
But we're so popular, as soon as you start typing in super, we're like one of the top four.
Okay. I just want to make sure they end up on the right thing.
It is for one fall, and it is for the vacant Skid Row Academy Tag Team Championship.
Oh, wow, we have another title match here.
Now, for those who were not here at our inaugural Friday Night Fully Charged.
Right.
Noah Stryker became one half of the Skid Row Tag Team Champions with AEW superstar Nick Camarado. Unfortunately,
right now we have the champs, Primal Fear, two-thirds of Primal Fear.
You know,
because
they don't already have enough gold around their waist. They're looking to put more.
Yeah, they're fixing to try to take all of it.
I mean,
it is what? Fear none, take all? They've been telling us the entire time.
I agree. And it would be awesome to see those tag titles unified.
Yeah.
To an undisputed tag team championship.
Undisputed.
Guys, if you can't see, those are new Super Crazy Pro Wrestling Tag Team Championship belts that Primal Fear is holding right now.
Just presented to them earlier before the began.
That is amazing. Hats off to Super Crazy with these unique titles. Now, as I was saying, due to contractual obligations, Nick Camarado was forced to vacate his half of the Skid Row Tag Team Championship, which unfortunately screws Noah Stryker out of his championship. But, what we see right now,
he's coming out with both belts.
As he should.
He believes he never lost. He never was pinned. He never submitted. So
he's
to
not
him,
wrong.
To him, he is the rightful champion.
And what better way than to have your actual partner,
right? Of the tag team, Crouching Tiger, Hidden Stryker, Noah Stryker, and Tiger Watson.
I'm rooting for these guys in this matchup. These guys
as Noah Stryker proudly holds up both belts, as you should.
And Gabriel Hodder's giving him praise, saying new champs right there.
Third tag team on their way to the ring.
We know who these guys are. Now, these guys have been started off rocky, but have been working very well together in recent months. To everyone's surprise.
AJ Frills, Frank Bonetti. Be an interesting situation occurring right now.
And it was these two that went against Stryker and Camarado for those Skid Row Tag Team Championships.
Stop like the giant here today. You got to swing the bomb. What is this? What do
you got to swing the bomb? There's a lot of energy, a lot of skill in this
Tiger
and KJ have a couple of words with each other. Don't know if you remember, a little while ago, KJ Thrills gave a low blow to Tiger Watson, which caused them a match.
KJ Thrills and Bonetti, look at him. Although, when you got a team like Primal Fear and Crouching Tiger, Hidden Stryker, honed in on just you guys. Yeah, I probably will. I'll hit you with that. I ain't dumb. I'm hot. Y'all ain't about to gang up on me.
The crowd is for Primal Fear right now. Strong lockup from Matthew Ullman and Noah Stryker. Pushing him off.
AJ Thrill still has some
and
hands.
Pretty hard. Shoulder tackle.
There you go, man.
Leg sweep. Oh.
Oh, man. Tripped him. Kicked him.
Athleticism shown by
that's
Matt.
That's right, old man. You show him, baby.
That all fight, no flight mentality.
There you go. Straight takes the wrist.
Come on, baby. Let's go. Let's go.
Oh. Yeah. Oh. Striker runs out of that, reverses it into a wrist lock of his own. He keeps it on. Flying pressure.
Basics work, Tia. The basics work.
Shaw. Clean drop kick from Nova Striker.
Striker! 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 Very mixed crowd. I'm gonna need some of that.
What are you doing?
Got some showboating from KJ Girls. If it's your time.
Brought in the hard way.
I mean, you're in now, so it's your time.
Oh, wait.
Double chops.
Oh, I see what happened. He blinked and I missed it. KJ Thrills with the blind tag on Matt Roman. Matt Roman not happy with that.
Holding him in place while Tiger flying.
Yeah, look at that. Like a well-oiled machine.
Teamwork.
You see what happens when you have your real partner by your side?
They do work more fluidly together, yes. Only the two count after all.
Now, hats off to Noah Striker. You're finding a partner in Nick Delgado.
Of course. Oh! KJ Thrills just slapped Gabriel Otter. I wouldn't do that if I was you. You know Gabriel's the crazy one out of Primal Fear.
He's definitely the taller.
Arm drag. Tiger Watson takes the arm. Using the ropes to his... Scissors. Take down.
You gotta do nothing like that.
No. Good.
Nobody home. Go to the face. We're going for a crossbody, gets caught. Oh, Gabriel. We mentioned his height. He also has some strength. Swinging his opponent. Just in circles. Kind of, okay, dizzy.
Gabriel Hotter.
And another one.
That's the primary fear. They're not in the ring. They're in the gym. Constantly working on their
physique.
Strength, conditioning, all that good stuff. And it shows. Every time they come out and perform, it shows. Oh.
Frank Bonetti takes Gabriel Holler out at the blade.
Do you love him or hate him? They're working like an oiled machine right now.
Not quite oiled, but a machine, yes.
I didn't say well.
New champion!
Noah has something to say about that.
So does Tiger Watson. Congrats to Tiger. Striker, they're just like, ah, this is what we think about your new champion.
It's almost like Tiger Watson and Noah Striker have something to prove. To prove that they are the rightful tag team champions. Oh no, you guys better turn around. This is how a real tag team does it. I don't know. Here we go. Teamwork.
Yeah. Well, obviously, Primal Fear, no strangers to tag team gold, as we know. Current crazy tag team champions. Like you said, fear none, take all.
Can't mess with Matthew Roman. Not only being very skilled to annoying, he also knows martial arts.
Oh.
You can't mess with Gabriel, he has a crop top.
Yes.
I mean,
yes. He definitely has a crop top.
That's a sign of a crazy person.
I mean, real men wear crop tops, do you? I prefer a pink one, but that's just me.
Throws, practically throws Frank Benetti into KJ.
No, practically. He threw. He said,
we. Going for the cover. Oh, only gets a two. KJ throws, kicks out. Does his candy, gets the shoulder up. Andrew Harder is getting the crowd into it.
Double striking with the tag.
Good,
right. Okay.
Some strikes in from the Striker. Oh, KJ throws him into the takes a foot to the face from Frank Benetti. Don't think that was on him.
That was a pretty big foot right to the face. Like, out of my toes.
Benetti's a move!
Benetti makes the tag.
Fake out.
Oh!
Breaker. Bad position.
He's trying to down. KJ Thorne is kind of celebrating. You know,
can't
Noah Striker here that night. Talk about his fight. We talk about his energy. He is fire personified. Noah Striker is the biggest prospect. Just can't put him down that easily. Matthew Omen's ready to go.
At this point, though, it's new. Striker's been well established in the Super Bowl.
He still calls himself the new
All right.
We're doing tag team wrestling. All right.
Oh, strong strike from KJ Thrills. Goes for the cover and a kick out.
Breath, not getting a chance to breathe. So many pinfalls. KJ and Striker, no strength in himself. Both Skid Row kind of graduates. Under the tutelage of Adrian Soriano.
Goes back to Striker. He's him up. Trying to get him forward. Body slam here. Connects the body slam. Kind of a cocky pin. No one kicks out.
See what I mean?
The cocky pin.
First cocky pin break. I don't think I've ever seen the cocky pin successful. At least not in a straightforward match. Intensity coming from the crowd.
Come on.
He makes the tag from Benetti entering. Knocks out Tiger Watson. Just to make sure that they stay on Noah Striker. Noah Striker makes the tag.
Omen like a ball of fire.
Matthew Omen's been waiting to get in for a while.
Yes, we'll see it.
Oh! That was a sneaky right.
Just because KJ didn't see it doesn't mean he's sneaky.
Yes, you're right. It was more quick and sharp than anything. It just wasn't expected.
It worked.
Roman Smart did not let them do the team
move. He took his head off. And
another one.
Head to the roller.
Practically decapitates him. Going for the cover. They're trying to figure out the legal person. A high crossbody from the agile Tiger Watson.
That mixed up may have just caused Prime to fear this match.
Yeah, I believe it. Can Tiger Watson capitalize with
dug down deep for that.
Get in here.
Red pass. Ready, tagging back to the big grills.
Everyone's looking pretty tired right now. With these two counts not quite being able to close the deal.
Oh, look at that.
Ooh. Oh, double super kick. Taking out KJ. Another one, too. Tiger Watson. Kicks for everybody. You get a super kick. You get a super kick. Everybody gets a super kick. KJ's going for his patent. He's caught.
That's it.
It's all for his head! All fight! Young boy! Let's go!
Oh, what is going on?
Learn the top!
Wait. Tony.
Is that Soriano?
Looks like it, yes.
And they're distracted from this matchup.
Okay, so.
But we still have a match going on.
So we still have Tiger Watson,
Bobo Striker. And
yes. So they have to keep going. Oh!
And that is
Frank Bonetti of the team of KJ Thrills and Frank Bonetti picks up the win.
Instead of basking in their victory,
he asked about why this song is
his song. Because he won the match.
Your new Skid Row Tag Team Champions, Frank Bonetti and KJ Thrills. Big things happening here at Super Crazy Pro Wrestling's Heartbreak.
Still complaining about the song. I hate this song. I hate it. Nah. Man.
1950s
games. Yeah, see, he said he hates the song, yeah. New tag team champ, yeah.
Impressive win nonetheless. That means we're going to see a lot more from them as they go on to defend those titles. It's okay, I get it wrong too. Gloucester.
You know, like Worcestershire song?
No.
It's spelled like Worcester. But you don't say that, you say Worcestershire.
Whoa!
Oh, okay. OG.
For real?
OG is super crazy.
Is that?
Yes, it is.
Donovan?
That is Sean Donovan.
Wow. I love some old school. Old school is the best school.
Oh, we know who they got. Donovan's student.
Oh!
He's facing Donovan. And he's our president. United States champion. Samuel Foster.
I haven't even said anything.
We don't need you.
See, yes, that's a full circle for Samuel Foster.
How I propose that this show is titled Heartbreak. Because when I look at this side, this side, this side,
it's a beautiful
and like
crowd.
The 10 people over here, it's really heartbreaking to know that all of you live in a town, in a county, that is not only riddled with crime in the state of New Jersey, but is one of the most crime-ridden states in all of the United States of America.
Go old school, I'm fine with going old school.
program. We're here right now.
Are you not allowed to be here?
Son, I dare you to step through these doors.
Okay, we're having words.
Sean!
I'll whip your ass worse than yesterday.
Mount Fuzzy is telling Donovan, hey. Yes, just a reminder, it's four. Another super title. I'm sorry, I see the audience right now and they are glaring. Just hatred at Donovan right now.
You, sir, what's 2 + 2?
4.
That's exactly the response I was looking for. Yeah. That's the reason why she's got no teeth.
Oh, disrespectfully throw. And that's what he has to say about throwing the shirt. And he throws it back at him. That's why Semi-Hell, Fozzy, is the president. He'll take what you give to him and double it. Raise you. Double.
Go all in. You gotta go all in.
Strong lockup into a headlock. Taking control of that arm. No. Clean reversal. From Fozzy. Hammer into a pin. Getting down to business very early. Clear disrespect from Donovan. Fozzy can't believe it.
Excuse me.
The father beat the child.
At some point, every son looks at their dad. This is his time. Another headlock.
If that's making it through.
That's a hero on that one.
Come on, kid. You're a kid in a man's world.
You're a kid. Kick out.
It might be reference to the promo that he did when he said strong.
Is this the trash that is taught at Skid Row Academy?
You from here too, asshole.
Somehow Fozzy is applauding some facts dropped by the crowd right now.
Want to throw bumps?
Body slam. Pretty tough. Fozzy had to roll out of the ring, catch his composure from that one.
Let's do this! Come on!
Do the champ!
Come on!
Strike to the back.
Any type of offense. And if he has,
not too much of it.
Has it been successful?
Massive,
dominant
chop right now.
Calm down, man. Sorry if you can't continue, man. Hey, he's hanging on those poles. Back up, man. Come on now, man. Get him off there.
tackle.
Why don't you?
Leapfrog. Nice hip toss. And another arm drag.
Roll up. Here we go.
Hey, you got him back.
That's scary. How you feel, Mr. Clean?
Huh?
How you feel,
Sonny? Mr. Clean!
What you mad?
Causey is asking Donovan what you mean. Don't be mad. Standing drop kick. That energy, that explosiveness from Fozzy is what you expect.
Donovan's feeling it now.
As he takes a little bit of a breather outside of the ring. Remember though, if you're giving yourself a breather, you're giving your opponent a breather. Oh, looked like he was going to go for a sliding kick. Broke that with an elbow. Pulls him back in by using the top ropes.
In the hard
right punches and a chop and another chop ducking. Oh, folds him on to the top. Closing line. Uses the knee to deliver a strike. I think you're right. Samuel Fawzi wasn't getting off much offense. I think that maybe there's some doubt.
I don't know about doubt. Definitely there's some surprise.
Attacking the body of his opponent. That's the fire that Samuel Fawzi had. If he's going to pull the victory over his opponent.
I can't say.
Overhand chops.
Like a truck. Okay.
Hey, come on, big
Get him off those ropes, man. Off the hair. Come on.
Grabbing his opponent by the hair.
All the ropes, man. Come on now. Whoa. And
just to keep the control.
Hair. Whoa.
Hey, Sean, you suck.
Throws that. Elbow drop. More frustration than anything from Fozzie at this point.
Watch the hair, Donovan. Come on down, man. Watch his hair.
Here again.
Yeah, he got one. Two. Because he doesn't.
The elbow straight to the forehead. Stretches him.
What do you say, man?
Yeah.
I'm going to go over there. That hurts.
Hey, watch the tight hair, man.
Turns it into a tossing. Oh, did a splash with the lead connected with the rib cage of Sam Alphonse.
Get up, get up!
Hey, ref, you're
my seat!
Double clothesline.
Wow. Both opponents are down right now. See who can get to their feet first. The crowd is rooting for Sam Alphonse.
Yeah, this is definitely not going to make the crowd at all.
As the senior official, Nick Shin, counts. You're going to get up.
You only have to get up to your knees to break that count.
Right, but while you're still in your vulnerable position,
absolutely.
If your opponent makes it up, straight boot to the face.
Oh. Answer to every call here.
He orders his opponent to get up. Uppercut. Oh, cut off by him. Kick to the torso. Inside going to the top rope. He's a bit dizzy on his feet.
Flying missile dropkick. This one.
Well
two.
Done.
Oh, wow. Donovan had to dig down deep for that one. So you gotta wonder how much Fozzie was taking out of Donovan.
It was a two. Sorry, guys. The audience is arguing right now about whether or not it was a two or a three. It wasn't either two. Sorry, guys.
The shoulders were up.
Alphonse is waiting for his opponent to turn around. So he can deliver. Oh, cut off. Donovan has Sam Alphonse on his shoulders. Pure power, pure strength.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh.
Wow. Wow. Where's Chan? Kicks out. I thought that was it, too. I thought it was it.
You both.
Hey, down!
Grab the
potato,
get up!
These two opponents have given so much. They're trying to get the other down. Donovan still has enough energy
mamas.
To talk about somebody's mother.
Yo, I'm talking about your mama.
Looks like Sam Alphonse clipped Donovan a little bit, stopped him in his tracks.
Yeah!
Oh.
He's throwing himself into his opponent. With the added speed of the run, gotta be a massive hit for sure. Sam Alphonse grabs the leg. Oh!
Ding dong! Ding dong!
Definitely thinking about right there.
Damn!
With a massive clothesline, he goes for the cover. And another kick out. I can't see Sam Al's face right now. His back is turned, but I'm sure he is now determined. He got that crazed look in his face.
I've seen that look before.
Exactly.
Usually doesn't bode well for his opponent. Oh! Donovan uses the rope.
That's old school right there. That's a vet.
That is very good ring awareness.
Knows how to use the ring.
Yeah!
Oh!
Oh! Ah, my back!
Choke slam.
Good night.
DDT.
Oh. He might be.
Wow. Whoa! He gets the shoulder up.
After his eyes nearly rolled to the back of his head, still managed to get that shoulder up at the last second.
Exactly.
Woo!
What tenacity, what determination, what just utter gall that be. Tonight is champion just brought out.
Hudson is standing up for his house.
At this point, how many more chops can he take?
Chest, right? He's gotta be damn near caved in by now.
He's now practically twisted in these ropes like a vine. Standing on the mid rope. Truly up to no good. Sam Alphonse is fighting back. Pushes him off. Oh, looks like
going for the flying elbow. Is it?
What? Oh!
You going back for that crucifix?
Oh!
Oh, and drop.
He gets it.
Son of a bitch!
Oh! He got him! He got him! One, two, three, and the president.
Still
the president
champion. Fozzy pulls off an impressive win over a former mentor of his, proving that he is champion for a reason.
The student has outdone the teacher here today. From humble beginnings to a young 18-year-old child. Well, I guess 18 is not really a child. But he was real young when he started.
He started, I think, at 17, now at 21, standing a champion.
First ever Skid Row heavyweight champion.
Carrying the company practically on his shoulders. Well done, an impressive victory, no doubt.
Still the United States champion, Sam Alphonse. Sean Donovan, good to see him back. For him, he's going home empty-handed. We don't know what's happening.
He was a tough opponent. He brought it. That's one thing you can say for sure. Here's David Adams.
What about you, Nick?
Oh, he said it right. Gloucester.
I still can't say it right. My bad.
Gloucester.
Don't get back into your hearts yet. But right now, it's all about Punk Parade. Here in Gloucester City, the action continues with this next contest. It is set for one fall.
Oh, I know this feeling. Yes.
Indeed. It's Deshaun Pratt.
A man I know very well. Grew up with this man. Went to high school with him.
Really?
Prince of Camden.
Prince of Camden.
That's my man. That's my boy, baby.
Been in the business for 17 years.
We already know, baby.
He let me know he's been in the business for 17 years and he's still going. Still going. Face anybody.
Still going. Been around.
He's royalty. He's the Prince of Camden.
He's into the big game.
Yeah. Oh. Here we go again with another teacher versus student.
Oh, yeah. We know this music. Devious
that one cast. If you didn't notice. So fun fact, Devious Cast, this was one of his first trainers at Skid Row Academy, Deshaun Pratt.
Yes.
Basically taught Cast everything he knows.
So it's going to be great to see if he can pull out what he's been taught.
Listen, it's just great to see Deshaun Pratt back in Super Crazy Pro Wrestling.
Of course, always.
Let's go, boy!
The former youngest Skid Row heavyweight champion.
Acknowledge him!
Please welcome to the commentary table. Here's the reigning Skid Row.
Oh.
Let me bring champion.
How come you ain't tell me?
I'm the genius, T.J. Reno.
Oh, it's always great to have T.J. Reno in the building.
Yeah. Apparently he's going to be guest. He has his own commentary.
Devious Cast had an impressive resume in his early career. Deshaun Pratt, so many accolades under his belt.
Let's not forget that the new Skid Row heavyweight champion.
In fact, Deshaun Pratt has wrestled on numerous occasions. T.J. Reno's father, the Alpha Tiger, basically grew up in the business together.
A lot of connections we made. T.J. Reno
traveled,
won the championship off of his cast recently. So there's probably no love lost between them at this moment.
Sean, giving respect where respect is due. Welcome to the table, champ. It's good to have you here.
Welcome.
Roger, shut up.
Let's
go, Cass. Bring him out. Can you focus? I know you took your belt. Can you
not
focus
at all.
Right
not
here?
At all. It's an honor to have you.
You took your belt, but can you focus you, here?
Whoop his ass.
Yeah.
That's it.
Whoop his ass.
Just talking about how the former champion has had an impressive career.
Say that one more time. Hang in my head, bro. I'm
the former champion. Yes.
He too small, Cass.
But his opponent, Sean Pratt, around the world. That's beyond it.
Okay. Do you have any predictions for this?
Come on, man. Turn it up. Come on.
See, Cass too hype for himself, you know, and I get it, you know, you got the championships and family that's supporting you, so that's why I had to lock him down.
Sometimes it takes that, you know, you just gotta be knocked down from your pedestal.
Pretty impressive training coming up right now.
Oh, absolutely. Like I said, the show prep, Ring of Honor, Chikara, CZW,
this is easy.
Impact at a certain point. Impact wrestling at that time.
Look,
uphill guard matches for the big guy. Rinse for a reason. I know him as something else, but we talking about Pratt.
I thought we were talking about Kaz. I know Kaz is former champ.
Yes, former champ. And to clarify, that's former with a capital F, champ. Current champ. Current champ, the legend himself, TJ Reno. Do I have to say it again? The current Skid Row heavyweight champion, TJ Reno.
Right now, I'm focus on the action. You can see that Sean Pratt is not letting up easy, but we have Devious Kaz taking over, using that natural strength that he has at such a young age.
Right, absolutely. You gotta wonder, does play a factor in this match? Sean in the ground, set himself 17 plus.
Right.
Kaz is just getting speed wet in this.
Oh, blocked the first kick.
Youngest champion, youngest former champion as well. But like I said, this is a teacher versus student matchup now. Sean was Devious Kaz's first trainer ever.
That's
exactly what it means. Right. Sometimes, you know what I mean? It's like a father beating on his child.
You can't take that.
He's got to. No!
He's arrogant for his own good.
At first, it was just about the championship.
Good body slam.
Right.
It was about the
follow up by elbow drop. Going for the cover. Only gets a two.
I wanted to make it for the championship.
Let's go, Kaz. Turn up.
One thing I know, once you get to that first level, it's a fight.
Alright,
no stranger to fights either. You don't call yourself the Prince of Camden for nothing.
Another cover.
I remember when Pratt used to wear purple. We won't say anything about that because he is the OG hunk.
I will say nothing about the purple. It's the color of royalty. That's what I'm just saying.
Good answer. Good job. Good answer.
Look at that. Tremendous athlete.
Tremendous. I mean, he's a football player.
That's just the type of person he is. I don't like it.
Devious Kaz is an athlete. Definitely showing some of his strength right there and quickness.
He got a taste and then thought his feet on stuff.
Worry about me too much. Worry about yourself. I'm telling you, worry about yourself. I'm not worried. Mind your business. Let me do what I'm doing. You worry about me too much.
Devious Kaz does have some words for you.
Loser is a relative term. You are the former champion. Look of surprise on Pratt's face.
I was three.
You can't. You ain't wrong. You ain't ever lied. I always say here, all it takes is that one mistake for that 1-2-3. And this could be Cassidy.
Worry about yourself. Worry about yourself. It was. Worry about yourself. You don't want it, I'm telling you.
He's lying. He's using Keyshawn Prep too.
He can't use it.
You for a second. He's to talking. Show you what he's
going to talking to you.
I mean,
and you do your job.
I mean, don't get me wrong. Wouldn't be impressive. That would be a huge knock.
And it may be held up really enough to why.
I mean, doesn't he get a rematch though?
Okay.
I'm a fighting champ. Absolutely.
And there's nothing wrong.
That's because you were brought up the right way, brother.
I mean, the world. I gotta agree with that. And if you read the overall comment,
That's
what I'm trying to teach you. Just focus.
I'm doing my job.
Just focus. You focusing on, I'm not your opponent tonight. Focus.
Sean's pulling himself up. Shaking up the cobwebs.
You need to turn around.
You don't want to give him some second up. Right to the face.
We're
going back and forth with strikes. Trainer versus trainee.
Shot for shot right now.
I believe so is the case. That fighting spirit.
Oh, I thought it was going to be a 3 for a second. That was almost a 3. Was it 2.5?
It has heart. He has heart, and that'll take him far in his business. It takes more than heart to succeed. And that's why he's a former champion. Super kicks for everyone.
Enemy.
Got him in his sights.
Oh.
Oh! Ass cutter.
Got him by the cover. He just pulled off a win. Devious Cass just pulled off a win off a 17-year vet, Deshaun Pratt.
Wow. Wow. Respect. Respect for sure.
I guess he feels good about himself.
I mean, doesn't matter who it's against. The win is always good.
You feel tough?
Ah, give him his props. That was an impressive win over the OG.
It was good. I'm gonna go handle something. Okay.
Handle your business, champ.
I think he's inviting you right now up there.
He's inviting you in there.
Is TJ gonna go in? Or is he just gonna walk away? Neither of these guys are the type to back down. So, yep, he is. He's obliging. He's casting his request for him to enter. A little shove from TJ.
Hey, calm down. Hey, calm down. You's a bitch.
Harsh words and now a brawl has broken out.
Can we get some order?
Wake this up, you guys.
Break it up, guys. Let's go.
I mean, the audience is now
requesting that they let them fight.
That's all fine and good, but this is not a sanction. This would not be a sanctioned fight.
Of course, of course. We just know now what the audience wants.
And I think we're going to get that rematch.
They're back at it again. These guys definitely are not each other's favorite.
Hey, this on you, man. This on you, man. Come on. I'll see you on the 23rd.
Back, TVS cast says, I'll see you. Which is Super Crazy Pro Wrestling's second fully charged show. Which is looking like it's going to be a pretty good show. But right now we're watching Super Crazy Pro Heartbreak. And we've had title changes. We've had unexpected victories. We've had brawls. We have more things coming up for you. And if you missed any of this, you can always go to YouTube and look up Super Crazy Pro Wrestling.
We reach out here Friday night, fully charged, February 23rd at the Skinner Academy. Make sure you check that out. With that said, I need your mic. There's one final question. Who's going to talk to one more match?
Seems like everybody has time for one more match.
Is a long time friend of mine. Oh, I know. You gotta know him. He used to hail by the name of Major McClendon out of the Monster Factory.
Major, really?
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Yes, everybody. Major McIntosh is performing this song right now.
I gotta talk to Major. I haven't talked to him in a minute. Well, coming to the ring right now.
There's another one I came up in this business.
Backed up by Tony Leyenda and Tony Bennett. Do a little dance on stage.
Yeah, baby, I've been it!
Baby, I've been it. Love it. Love this song. Baby, I've been it. Shout out to Major McIntosh for the track.
Woo! The crowd is a little mixed. A little mixed perception.
That's because this crowd has no respect.
Tony, you gotta have respect for the crowd. And of course, Super Fresh himself. Adrian Soriano. There's so many opinions, so much history going on right now with this particular match. It's difficult to say or to even guess what may happen.
course, Adrian Soriano being backed by Gabriel Hodder and Matthew Ullman, his Primal Fear teammates.
Listen, love him or hate him, Adrian Soriano is the interim. Yeah, I said it. Interim heavyweight champion. Who now has to defend that interim heavyweight champion against the other Tony. Tone Bennett. I'll be right back. It's that time again.
Oh, no. It is shot o'clock, apparently, here at Super Crazy. The second time. It's okay. I'm going to stay here and call it like I see it.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is for Super Crazy Pro Wrestling Heartbreak, featured out of the afternoon. Is this one for one for all?
Interim Super Crazy Pro Heavyweight Championship. Wow, there was a symphony of boos for Tony Bennett. Soriano will defend his title against whomever he has to, but he doesn't like that interim part of it. Oh man, we got some words, we got some shoving right now. Everyone definitely ready to go. But guys, this match is only between Tony Bennett and Adrian Soriano. There's a clear banning. So Tony Leanda cannot be there. Gabriel Hodder cannot be there. Matthew Ullman cannot be there as this match is going on. And the crowd is saying goodbye.
One, two, three,
all fight, no fight!
The crowd is pretty much 100% behind Primal Fear. Tony Bennett has a little sip of his crunch juice right there. Adrian Soriano seems like he doesn't need a sip. Because he's all fighting the flight.
You gotta go!
The crowd is specifically saying goodbye to Tony Leanda. At this point, I'm not sure what the crowd wants, but it is interesting to see them now voice their opinion directly to the wrestlers. Starting out with strikes back and forth, just pummeling one another. Sure, y'all take it over with forearms to the face. Oh, Tony uses the hair. Tries to hit the turnbuckle, but he stopped. Bit of a chop there from Soriano to Bennett.
Let's go for a trip!
Oh, hits the turnbuckle, chops. And again, looks like we're going around the world right now. Completed the trip around the world. Bennett is definitely feeling it right now. Lou's back in here.
That's why you're the new voice.
Good job.
Good job.
Good job. Thank you more time.
Sit!
I know that trick! Well, no!
Bye-bye!
Crossbody!
Soriano, well known all around the states. One third of Pine Field. But Tone Bennett, no stranger himself, he's been around, he's been to the big game. He's been all over the country, all over the world. Both men are deserving of that title. I might be biased because I follow the tone, but I don't want to take anything away from Soriano. He deserves a champion. Interim champion. It's hard for me to say he's a real champion.
Right now, the ref is. Oh!
Although I like his pants.
Just tossed it. The drink it to his face. So disrespectful.
And the ref didn't call that though? Well, he didn't cheat.
Or flight.
You gotta fight, not cheat.
That's a martini flight. Shit. We do this deal.
Telling the cameraman to move out the way. Straight into the turnbuckle. With a chop of his own. Turnbuckle chop combo.
When in doubt, chop it out.
And another chop.
When in doubt, big E out.
Don't like that!
You have to start. SpongeBob.
He's checking his hand. He's alright.
He takes a bow.
Now you got something for you!
Oh, missed that one. Another miss.
Wasted too much time.
Oh! Finally connects. Sorry, I'm finally connects the chop.
Got you now. Come on. Come on, you idiot.
Tries to get him up. There we go.
Better shut that down real quick.
He fell on his knee.
Tony
Bennett has some worries for the ref right now. Looks like he's or he's grabbing something.
Hey! Put that away! Hey!
I can't see right now what he has.
Hats off to the referee for doing his job.
Hey!
Hey, put that down. Hey, what are you doing? Hey,
what are you
what's
doing?
Going on right now?
What are you doing?
I'm tying it.
He's getting up. He's exposing the turnbuckle right now.
As the ref is making sure that Anthony Sorrell is being cautious.
What are you doing? What?
You're fighting with
Sue! Sue!
Going for right, shot for shot.
It's become a fight.
Takes him out. Leg. Ooh, with a follow-up kick to the face.
Across the head, though.
Pretty good back and forth combos there. It shows that both opponents have a great level of athleticism.
Oh, and then some.
Yeah. Bennett flings his body onto the top rope. Causing a reverberation that brings down Adrian Sorrell.
I mean, you gotta have massive balance when you're climbing up there. Any tip, which way, is set in the
grabs the hand of Soriano. Completed up. Oh! Definitely was not trying to take out the ref, but the ref is down right now. From a massive super kick from Adrian Soriano.
Every time.
Can they get another ref up? Oh,
and the ref is down?
The ref is down. Bennett is thinking about something. He is definitely up to no good right now.
Can we get another official out here? I'm gonna check on the referee.
Bennett is walking, he's strutting off right now as Adrian Soriano is feeling the effects of the attack. Where's he going?
I'm tired of this little girl.
He's grabbing the title.
Listen, I like you and all, Bennett, but you haven't won the match yet.
Ooh, we have a duck. A clothesline. Okay, everyone is down at this point. What is going on? Oh, we have Tony Leonda coming out.
Real champ coming out.
A champion. One of the champions coming out. It looks like as if like he's positioning himself, readying himself for Adrian to get up. And another duck. Oh!
Is that a tooth?
Okay. We have another duck. Oh! Tony on Tony Violence right there.
I like that. Tony on Tony Violence.
I knew you would. That's why I said it. We need some milk.
Somebody get the referee some milk.
Is that a figure four from Adrian Soriano?
Ben is tapping.
Ben is tapping.
Ref is still down.
Someone get another ref.
Someone get another ref down here.
Adrian Soriano attempts to wake up the ref himself. And his attack from the back by Tony Leyenda.
You know what Leyenda means?
No, I don't speak Spanish.
Legend.
Okay.
Primal fear!
They're they're calling out Primal Fear.
Oh, and here they come.
And they're listening.
But nobody says Super Fresh. How did they manifest themselves?
They're not Super Fresh. Adrian Soriano.
Yeah, but you said when you say Super Fresh, Primal Fear comes out.
I said Adrian will show up.
Listen, we're going to go to the tape after tonight.
We can go to the tape. I doubled down on what I said. I said.
Get you a cheeseburger in my mouth.
There's a whole entire brawl happening.
And we still have no referee.
And the ref is still out.
The referee is still dead.
Adrian Soriano just sent himself into the brawl itself. Just used his whole body as a tool. Landed on his knees, a little rocky. Bennett comes back with a strike.
Yo, the ref is dead, folks. Dead. Can we get another referee out here? Hey, check the ref.
Goes for the cover.
Check the ref.
The ref is still out.
The ref is dead.
So we've had a tap out. We've had a cover. We've had a dive.
Oh, the ref is moving.
The ref is coming back.
He's like a little cockroach. He's moving. Look at him. That was the first bug I thought of.
Headbutt from Tony Bennett. Can he turn it into a...
Oh!
Adrian Soriano gets that shoulder up, though.
I mean, in Bennett's defense, that was a pretty slow count from that referee.
He is trying to wake him up.
Well, they shouldn't have killed him.
They should have killed him, Frank. Don't, if you want to win your match, don't kill your ref. That
is words to live by for every wrestler in this game. If you really want to win, do not kill the ref.
He's waiting. Grabs his opponent. Sends knee after knee after knee.
Knee.
Into the exposed turnbuckle. Super kick.
Super fresh, super kick.
He's going to the top rope. What is he going to do? Splash!
Rock splash.
He pulls off the win. Wow.
And still your interim heavyweight champion.
An amazing win by Adrian Soriano.
That it was. A lot of back and forths in that match. A
lot.
But I will not take it away. I'll give respect where respect is due. And Adrian Soriano pulled off the victory to retain his interim heavyweight championship.
Watching Super Crazy Pro Wrestling's Heartbreak.
Join us here again February the 23rd for our second.
Whoa, what's going on? Thank you.
Primal Fear, dominant here at Skid Row and Super Crazy. We look forward to seeing you all Friday night, February the 23rd. A great Friday night of fights. Will we see that big match between Devious Cass and TJ Reno for the Skid Row heavyweight title? That possibility and so much more. For the Skid Row Academy, for Super Crazy Pro Wrestling, O-Dog and the crew, I'm Demon Adams. Thank you so much for sharing this Saturday afternoon of Heartbreak. We're signing off from the Pine Grove Civic Association. Thank you, Gloucester City, New Jersey. Good night. Come, get home safe. Thank you.